Welcome back to Survival Preparedness for Beginners. And today we're going to be talking about some of the tools that you're going to need if you're going to be in the woods, survival, camping, covers just about anything and everything. Right down to the little, dinky, small, little knives. So that's coming up next on Survival Preparedness for Beginners. Stay tuned. So welcome back to Survival Preparedness for Beginners. And as you all saw before, we're going to be talking about tools and some of the tools that you may need if you're going to be out in the woods or if you're in a survival situation, or maybe you're just going on a camping trip. Some of these things you're probably going to want to pick up, and you're probably going to want to have some of these on hand. Some of them you don't want to leave home without. We'll get to those in a minute. So let's start off with the first thing. The good old bull saw. All right, this is a Culligan's. It's a collapsible, very simple to use. Folds all the way around. You just gotta line up the little ends there so she'll slide right through like so. Then you just have to take and line up the screw inside, pop it on. And once you pop it on, you bend it over, you lock it in place, and you have yourself a folding bandsaw that you can take out. Very sharp, just like one you would have if you bought a regular one that doesn't collapse. And these are relatively inexpensive. Just about everything that I'm going to be showing you today will cost you less than everything except for two things will cost you less than $40. So this is going to be a good little video for the beginners. Fold this back around, and voila, she's all locked in place. There you go. It'll fit right through your backpack. In the back on a Mopac, it'll slide right through those. Good to go. Got your saw. Next, now I've talked about SOG in a couple of my videos. Now I'm not getting anything from them or anything else, but they make a lot of good beginner stuff, all right? Now, when you do get this stuff, it is dull, so you're gonna have to sharpen it yourself. I sharpened this before my trip last year. It does come with a little sleeve, since you can just lock right in. She wraps right around. And they're really good. It's really sturdy. All their stuff is really well made. And like I said, it is very good for the beginner. Okay? Now, moving on with the same type, Husqvarna. This I paid $95 for. All right, now I didn't go cheap on an axe because, you know, it's just something you didn't want to go cheap on. Now when I got this, this sucker was razor sharp, and it is very well made. It's a good, you know, good heavy little axe, nice big, as you can see here. So it's a really, really, really good axe. And like I said, the nice thing was is when it came, I did order mine and it came with the sheath that came with it. And it was sharp when it came, which for some reason you're gonna find that that's very rare for things to come already sharp and ready to go. Most of the time you get this stuff and you gotta sharpen it. It's either dull or barely sharp at all, you know? So it's gonna need sharpening. There are a few things that I have bought that didn't require that, and that was one of them. And like I said, that was a little under $100. All right, so that was the most expensive thing on this table that you saw. All right, moving right along. If you're gonna be out in the woods, especially if you're not gonna be on a trail or something, I would highly suggest having a machete. A machete has several different, you know, you can chop with it, you can split with it, you clear brush with it, you clear a trail. It does have the saw blade in the back. It's just going to be your friend all the way around. So if you're going to be going in a situation where it's just like not a normal camping trip, you want to make sure that you got a machete. All right, save yourself the trouble. How many times and again do we watch either our YouTube videos, TV shows, or anything else, and everybody's trying to cut through the branches and the brush and everything else? You know, just bring a machete. You know, you just chop it away and you can get through there without, you know, killing yourself, ripping your pack, cutting yourself. You know, it just makes everything so much easier. All right, now a pole. All right, so this is made for debarking a tree. All right, so you know, if you, this would be more of a survival tool. All right, so if you had to debark something, if you're building something out in the woods and stuff like that, this would come in really handy. And this did come pretty sharp as well. And this was about $65. They make them in all different sizes. You can find them all over the place. Some of them do. This one came with this little rubber strap that went on here to cover up the blade, but it doesn't stay on, so it's like useless. I have to find one that's more like a leather, and that way there it'll stay on, and maybe I can, you know, it's got some snaps or something to protect it. All right, let's get into a few knives. Now, this knife right here, this basically is your survival knife. All right, this is a... if somebody's coming after you, this is the knife that you want to get. You know, it's a double blade on both sides. This one is dull. When you buy them, they're dull. You know, it's from MTech. You know, it's the same as this right here. All right. But this one came sharp, but this one came dull. Go figure. I just don't get it. But this is more of your protection. If you're in a bad situation and you need protection, that's more of a knife you want to go with as far as that goes. My MOA, I just can't say enough about, you know, my MOA knives. I mean, they're just all around a great knife. Comes with a nice little case. Does have a hole in the bottom. It's solid plastic. This one here does have the fire rod on it, so you can strike that. Does have a small sharpener on the side also. I haven't used this. I use a regular, I have a different stone and stuff that I use, but it does have this right on here if you needed to sharpen something really quick. back to this little knife here. This is an MTech, and it's a little neck knife, and it's just a small little thing. But when it came, it's sharp. It's like, why doesn't, you know, the other, same company, but, you know, and this is nice because you can just put it around your neck and it's right there in case you need something real quick. You know, out of self-defense, it's a pretty small blade, but I mean, it would work in a sense. But you know, just if, you know, you're doing something, say you're trying to, you're cutting line, you're trying to cut something up or whatever, you know, you got a quick little knife right there and it's really razor sharp. All right, moving on over. This one is a Mazi Oak. All right. Now this is that's a big knife. All right. Now you can see the thickness on that knife. Now this knife would be really good. Obviously, you know, it comes with the, run it right through your belt loop and everything else. But this would be good if you had to split wood or something like that. I mean, it's nice and it's thick and it goes all the way through, and it's going to take a beating. So this way here, you know, if you needed to cut some wood and you needed to get some stuff done, that would be a very good knife to do that with. Now this knife over here, this one was given to me. it's called a Defender Extreme. Now, if you guys can see that, all right, it's made in China. Go figure, huh? All right, now, this, when you look this up, it's only like a $15 knife, all right? And there's not really much to it. You know, like I said before, it is dull and it is concave like this, and they put it off as their deer hunting knife. It does have a nice piece of paracord and stuff attached to it. It goes around the whole handle here. I don't know exactly how many feet that would be. It doesn't say on the website. The handle grip, as far as if the paracord's there, is pretty nice. I mean, there's a place there for your thumb. I can see where maybe if you had to, you know, clean a deer or something like that, a wild animal, that may work. You were definitely gonna have to sharpen that sucker back up. Like I said, this knife was given to me. It's just not one of my cup of tea knives, but in a sense, it would work in a pinch. Okay, we're getting down. There's just a few more knives here to talk about. All right, we're gonna start off with the French. Now, the French really know what they're doing, all right? They really know what they're doing when they make knives, all right? This is a open L, all right? It's just this little knife, okay? That could be a pocket knife, all right? It's a little big, but I mean, it still could be a pocket knife. Has a twisting mechanism right here that locks it, all right? Now, when you order one of these, this is a number 7, okay? Number 7 knife. When you get this bad boy, you order it on Amazon, they'll ship it right to you, all right? Less than 20 bucks, and that thing there, you could skin anything. Now, I would use that if I was hunting and I needed to skin a deer, skin whatever, a turkey, whatever it is you're hunting. You know, maybe it's a raccoon, maybe whatever it is, fish, fillet fish, you know, leave it to the French to come up and make sure that when you receive a product, it is razor sharp. So under 20 bucks, they have different sizes, and a lot, most of them all are under 20 bucks. Now you can spend a little bit more if you want. You can actually get a little pouch that this will go into, and it does connect to your belt. All right, now, we all know about Swiss Army knives, all right? Now as a kid, most people all, you know, most guys, you know, you always wanted a Swiss Army knife when you were a kid. You know, it was probably the first thing that you wanted, you know, it was the biggest thing back in the day, all right? Now I bought mine, this one right here, doesn't really have too many attachments to it. It's got your main blade, and it's got small blade, and then two small, you know, it's like a little, you got a screwdriver at that end, another can opener, and this side here is same thing, only just a little bit smaller. Then the back side is my corkscrew. This knife is really old. There's some of these things that haven't been opened in years. And then just my punch. So that's all that's on this one. You know, you got 4 on this side and 2 on this side. There's 6, you know, 6 things on here. So nowadays, you can go on Amazon, and actually I have one that I'm looking at, and you can go on Amazon and you can spend, some of these Swiss Army knives right now are running like $300-$400. It's just ridiculous. It has, I mean, the thing is like this wide, you know, I mean, there's no way you're going to carry that in your pocket, but it's got every tool known to man on it. You probably could fix your car. So, but the one I'm looking at, you know, it does have quite a few more attachments. It's like $80. So what I did was, is I put it in my cart, my Amazon cart, and I leave it there and save it for later, all right? Now, this is the trick, people, all right? This is how you can get around. You have to trigger the algorithm with Amazon, all right? Because all these companies have algorithms. Now, they know that you have said item in your cart, all right? Now, don't forget that. If you notice, every once in a while, every day or two, you're going to get notified that certain items in your cart have either increased or decreased. And you go in there and you keep watching them. And what I do is, a lot of my stuff, I don't pay a full price for. I wait till them to lower the price more than a few pennies, because you're going to get that. They're going to throw that thing at you. You're going to think, oh, I got a deal. And boom, yeah, that's only a couple pennies, you know. But, you know, the next thing you know, they take 10, 20 bucks off of it, you know, because the prices do fluctuate that much, believe it or not, you know, and they can take, and that's when you want to buy your products. So you throw everything in your save for later cart and play the game with Amazon. They love it. He's rich. He's got enough money. So Swiss Army knife is probably, you know, one of the most multi-tools that are out there as far as, you know, what you can get on there and how much money you really want to spend. Now, this pocket knife right here is pretty old. It was my father's. And when it boils right down to it, you could go and buy yourself a $10 pocket watch. I mean, not a watch. You can get a watch right there. You want to get a knife, we'll get back on track here. And that could be the difference between survival and not surviving. Because, you know, I mean, you got two blades. That's all that comes on this thing. All right? And this side here used to be a file, but that's pretty much gone. I'm guessing my father must have used the crap out of it. And a bottle opener. And then just your standard knife. Now, my father did keep all his knives razor sharp. All right? So, I mean, I don't use this. I don't carry it around with me because, you know, I don't want anything to happen to it because it's older than me. But the point of this is a small pocket knife could save you in a survival situation. If you had some way to clean fish, if you had some way to clean a rabbit, trim some bark or something, if you needed to make some twine, just little things, but that could be a lifesaver. And a little $10 pocket knife that you can just throw right in your pocket could be the difference of life and death. So, now we're going to throw in a couple bonus things. So if you are going on a camping trip, you're going on a hiking trip, you're going tracking out through the woods and stuff and everything else, you want to make sure that you have some type of protection with you, you know, in case of a wild animal or whatever else. So you want to make sure that you have a thing of mace. Now, if you're going to bear country, you want bear spray, not mace, but you want bear spray. And it's different size, you know, the whole nine yards. But at least if you have something for some type of a self-defense against a wild animal or just some idiot out in the woods, mace is the way to go. This way you keep yourself out of jail. Now, the next thing is a compass. If you're going to be going on a trip and you're going to, you're going camping, you're going hiking, you're hiking a long trail, you're doing whatever, you know, you want to make sure that you learn how to use one of these bad boys. All right. It's pretty simple once you get it down pat. You're going to have to watch quite a few videos and make sure that you understand at least how to use your bearings and your eyepiece here so that you can, you know, you get a bearing on something and that's where you want to keep heading towards. You know, it's just a standard thing that I think anybody that is going to be going out into the woods should have in their pack, on themselves, or whatever else, you know. And now this is another little item, you know, when it comes down to your compasses that you can spend a lot of money on. You know, I think this one here cost me about $40. You know, they get real expensive and, you know, some of them will do a lot of things and everything else. And it's all in what your comfort zone is. So, this has been Survival Preparedness for Beginners. And today we have been talking about some of the gear and tools that you're going to need if you're going to be going out into the woods, if you're going on a camping trip, or if you're going on a hiking trip, or if you're just going out for the day. Or maybe you're hiking a long trail and you're going to be gone for a few months. But you're going to need some of these things here on this table to make sure that you make a successful trip, you survive, and you get back home safe. Because that's what it's all about. We want to go out and have fun, but you want to make sure you're getting home safe. Now, if it's a survival situation and the end of the world has come, well then, all bets are off. And you need these tools to survive, defend yourself, and make sure that you can kill something and eat it. Point blank. So, survival preparedness for beginners. And until next time, I'll catch you all on the flip side.